Yo, what's good? It's the St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. Today I'm checking out the Scarbee Classic EP-88s. This is a dedicated EP library, kind of an update to the Mark I, but it goes above and beyond in terms of just flexibility, functionality, and some of the technology under the hood of it. This is a dedicated Kontakt Player library, so it will work in Kontakt Player. It also is NKS, so it automatically maps inside a machine and complete control. So what I want to do, of course, is go in and show you around the interface, but most importantly, show you what it sounds like. Let's check it out. All right, so here's the EP-88s interface. Really clean interface. The Scarbee Mark I is probably one of the first, EP libraries that I reviewed back when it came out in like 2010. It was definitely dope. There's been a lot of releases since then. So I want to see where this one stacks up. I've had it for a while. They sent it over for me to check out, but just now getting some time to actually play with it and definitely wanted to show it to you guys. So here's the interface, really clean. You got your vibrato up here, stereo, stretch tuning, 88 key model. So if you click this, it kind of gives it more of a vintage sound. Then you got the keyboard amp, or you can go straight passive. You can calibrate your key action. You can turn on a high-end cable, so it kind of gives you a little bit more clarity in the sound. The high-end cable is off. It gives you more of that vintage sound. You got this pre-attack control. They got a lot of stuff under the hood in terms of the playability to give it sounds like release, you know, samples and this pre-attack control and stuff, just to kind of get some of that sound before you actually hit the time or the hammer hits the time. You get a little bit of sound. So some of that stuff in there, if you want to go in and calibrate, you can do that. Kind of show which keyboard you got and then just play it so we can see what your velocity is like. So you have that. Then you got your effects over here, which is really cool. Zone EQ kind of lets you EQ the individual zones, so you can actually split it and get the, you know, the low and the high and EQ that all together, low, mid, high, or you can just do them all at the same time. So you got that. Got an external amp. If you're using this one, then the keyboard amp on the front page will not work. Then you got your different effects that you can tune in at any one you want to use. Just kind of click, then you go down there. There's also presets in there. So really cool stuff, and you can change the routing and the way everything is affected. So this thing is pretty cool, man. And then you just got some settings over here for your instrument noise and your note off delay, your pedal down, your pitch drift for the actual bass notes. So you got to get a little bit of a chorus effect when it's normal, kind of that vibration from the different keys and stuff. And then you can kind of edit that. You got your credits. So really straightforward interface, man. But I'm just starting with the straight dry. So one thing I will say about when I first started playing this, man, just the response and the way it plays really, really feels natural. And then just the velocity response, of course. Sounds real. And any of you that have been following me for a while, you know I'm just a huge fanatic of the Rode sound. So and even the way that they do the release samples, so if you release it quicker, sounds different than if you, and all that little stuff adds up to just, really, really dope sound. Now if we go and turn this on, I'll give it a little bit of a different, off, we'll have the passive, so see, it's just a little different sound. So let's do, turn this on. So even just on this front panel, man, you can really get creative. Maybe you want to turn on some vibrato. Dope stuff. And then you know, you got some effects. So it's really simple, really straightforward, but man, Just the sound quality is really dope, and then just the feel of it, the way it plays, I'm really impressed. I mean, with so many different EP libraries out there, I gotta say, man, like, they sent this one over for me to check out a few months ago, and I've been sleeping on it, man. There's so many other things going on, but once I actually sat down and played this thing, man, it just sounds good. So, you got stuff like, it's real quick to go in and start changing. And like I said, you got presets for these different effects. So, if you want to do that. So dope. So you got that. Let's do maybe a couple. Do a straight. Oh, let's do this. Let's go back over here. Got that little bit of a vintage sound. And some of that high end, you turn this on, goes away. Depends on what you're looking for. Another thing that's pretty cool is able to high end. That adds a little bit of clarity. As opposed to an older cable, which I actually prefer that one. But again, you got the flexibility. So let's go through a couple. And I think just the straight raw sound is beautiful, man. Even before you start getting into the presets. Everything works together for the playability, man, to give a realistic sound. And they also got some pretty cool stuff with the pedal up and down effects if you're using a sustain pedal. I don't have one hooked up. And then you got a bunch of processed presets. So let's go through some of these. Let's see. I mean, I'm not going to do every one, but that just sounds good, dude. That sounds really good. Thank you. think it sounds incredible, man. Like, I think they really, not only did they nail the sound, but it's the way it plays. The way it just responds to velocity and all the stuff they got going on under the hood, so. Just even those release samples, man. And how they're based on velocity and sustain and how long you're holding, and it's really dope. Let's see, maybe a couple more. I mean, hopefully you get the idea. Makes me want to play all of them. All right, I know I said one more. Let's do this one. Let's just do the last one. Hey, man, like I said, you can always go in. You can even change the way it goes so you can see effects one, keyboard amp. Just changing the effects routing. So really, really dope, man. I love the sound of this. Like I said, I was sleeping on this one, man. Like, you know, there's so many different EP libraries out there. But, you know, once I sit down and play with this thing, man, this is really, really well done. The overall sound quality is dope. And just the playability and the way it responds to your individual playing, plus all the little things that you can go in and tweak. Super, super dope. Overall, man, I give this a 5 out of 5 subs. I think this thing is incredible. Definitely at the top of my list in terms of you know, just EP libraries, man. I love it. As you can see, this is, it's in my default template now inside of Live, man. So really dope, man. Just the way it sounds, the way it plays, all the release samples, all the options you have for really tweaking and making it your own. They definitely paid a lot of attention to detail and just the playability, the way it sounds, the way it feels, the way it plays. They really took note of that and really made that a great experience. So, of course, you can get this directly from the Scarbee website. You can see the information right there, $127.76. Just really dope. Again, this works in the Kontakt Player. So if you have the free Kontakt Player, this works. It's also in KS format. So if you're using Complete Control or if you're using Machine, then you can directly control the parameters of this. But man, I'm telling you, from just the default sound to all the presets, this is a really, really dope library. You can go down, read all the information, check out all the features and everything that they have going on. But overall, man, I just think this thing is really dope. This is definitely something you need to check out. 5 out of 5 subs. The Scarbee Classic EP-88s. Really dope. I love it. Let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Again, this is St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. Let me know what you think below. Share this video if you dig it. And I'll see y'all later. Peace.